Drum and bass. Drum and bass, also written as drum and bass or drum and bass, commonly abbreviated as DNB, DNB or DNB, is a genre and branch of electronic music which emerged from rave and jungle scenes in Britain during the early 1990s. The style is often characterized by fast breakbeats, typically 160 to 180 beats per minute, with heavy bass and sub-bass lines, sampled sources, and synthesizers. The popularity of drum and bass at its commercial peak ran parallel to several other homegrown dance styles in the UK, including big beat and hard house. Drum and bass incorporates a number of scenes and styles. A major influence on jungle and drum and bass was the original Jamaican dub and reggae sound. Another feature of the style is the complex syncopation of the drum track's breakbeat. Drum and bass subgenres include breakcore, ragga jungle, hardstep, darkstep, techstep, neurofunk, ambient drum and bass, liquid funk, deep, drumfunk, funkstep, sambass, dnbnoise, and drill and bass. From its roots in the UK, the style has established itself around the world. Drum and bass has influenced many other genres like hip-hop, big beat, dubstep, house, trip-hop, ambient music, techno, jazz, rock and pop. Drum and bass is dominated by a relatively small group of record labels. The major international music labels had shown very little interest in the drum and bass scene, until BMG Rights Management acquired Dram in February 2016. Drum and bass remains most popular in the UK, although it has developed scenes all around the world, in countries such as the United States, Germany, the Netherlands, Belgium, New Zealand, Greece, Canada, Austria, the Czech Republic, Slovakia, and Australia. In the late 1980s and early 1990s, a growing nightclub and overnight outdoor event culture gave birth to a new electronic music style in the rave scene, which combined sampled syncopated beats or breakbeats, and other samples from a wide range of different musical genres and, occasionally, samples of music, dialogue and effects from films and television programs. A faster subgenre was known as hardcore, but from as early as 1991, some musical tracks made up of these high-tempo breakbeats, with heavy bass lines and samples of older Jamaican music, were referred to as jungle techno, a genre influenced by Jack Smooth and Basement Records, and later just jungle, which became recognized as a separate musical genre popular at raves and on pirate radio in Britain. It is important to note when discussing the history of drum and bass that prior to jungle, the music was getting faster and more experimental. Professional DJ and producer CK states, "There was a progression as far as the speed of music is concerned. Anyone buying vinyl every week from 1989 to 1992 noticed this." By 1994, jungle had begun to gain mainstream popularity and fans of the music, often referred to as junglists, became a more recognizable part of youth subculture. The genre further developed, incorporating and fusing elements from a wide range of existing musical genres, including the ragamuffin sound, dance hall, MC chants, dub bass lines, and increasingly complex, heavily edited breakbeat percussion. Despite the affiliation with the ecstasy-fueled rave scene, jungle also inherited some associations with violence and criminal activity, both from the gang culture that had affected the UK's hip-hop scene and as a consequence of jungle's often aggressive or menacing sound and themes of violence, usually reflected in the choice of samples. However, this developed in tandem with the often positive reputation of the music as part of the wider rave scene and dance hall-based Jamaican music culture prevalent in London. By 1995, whether as a reaction to, or independently of this cultural schism, some jungle producers began to move away from the ragga-influenced style and create what would become collectively labeled, for convenience, as drum and bass. As the genre became generally more polished and sophisticated technically, it began to expand its reach from pirate radio to commercial stations and gain widespread acceptance circa 1995 to 1997. It also began to split into recognizable subgenres such as jump up and hardstep. As a lighter and often jazz-influenced style of drum and bass gained mainstream appeal, additional subgenres emerged including techstep, circa 1996 to 1997. Which drew greater influence from techno music and the soundscapes of science fiction and anime films. The popularity of drum and bass at its commercial peak ran parallel to several other homegrown dance styles in the UK, including big beat and hard house. But towards the turn of the millennium, its popularity was deemed to have dwindled as the UK garage style known as speed garage yielded several hit singles. Speed garage shared high tempos and heavy bass lines with drum and bass, but otherwise followed the established conventions of house music, with this and its freshness giving it an advantage commercially. London DJ slash producer CK says, "It is often forgotten by my students that a type of music called garage house existed in the late 1980s alongside hip house, acid house and other forms of house music." He continues, "This new garage of the mid-90s was not a form of house or a progression of garage house. The beats and tempo that define house are entirely different. This did cause further confusion in the presence of new house music of the mid-1990s being played alongside what was now being called garage. Despite this, the emergence of further subgenres and related styles such as liquid funk brought a wave of new artists incorporating new ideas and techniques, supporting continual evolution of the genre. To this day, drum and bass makes frequent appearances in mainstream media and popular culture, including in television, as well as being a major reference point for subsequent genres such as grime and dubstep and successful artists including Jason Status, Netsky, and Australia's Pendulum. Drum and bass incorporates a number of scenes and styles, from the highly electronic, industrial sounds of techstep through to the use of conventional, acoustic instrumentation that characterize the more jazz-influenced end of the spectrum. The sounds of drum and bass are extremely varied due to the range of influences behind the music. Drum and bass could at one time be defined as a strictly electronic musical genre, with the only live element being the DJ's selection and mixing of records during a set. Live drum and bass using electric, electronic and acoustic instruments played by musicians on stage emerged over the ensuing years of the genre's development. A very obvious and strong influence on jungle and drum and bass, thanks to the British African Caribbean sound system scene, is the original Jamaican dub and reggae sound, with pioneers like King Tubby, Peter Tosh, Sly, and Robbie, Bill Laswell, Lee Perry, Mad Professor, Roots Radix, Bob Marley and Buju Banton heavily influencing the music. This influence has lessened with time but is still evident with many tracks containing ragga vocals. As a musical style built around funk or syncopated rock and roll breaks, James Brown, Al Green, Marvin Gaye, Ella Fitzgerald, Gladys Knight and the Pips, Billie Holiday, Aretha Franklin, Otis Redding, The Supremes, The Commodores, Jerry Lee Lewis and even Michael Jackson, are funky influences on the music. Jazz pioneer Miles Davis has been named as a possible influence. Blues artists like Lee Belly, Robert Johnson, Charlie Patton, Muddy Waters and B.B. King have also been cited by producers as inspirations. Even modern avant-garde composers such as Henrik Gorecki have received mention. One of the most influential tracks in drum and bass history was Amen Brother by the Winstons, which contains a drum solo that has since become known as the Amen Break, which after being extensively used in early hip-hop music, went on to become the basis for the rhythms used in drum and bass. Kevin Saunderson released a series of bass-heavy, minimal techno cuts as Reese/The Reese Project in the late 80s, which were hugely influential in drum and bass terms. One of his more famous bass lines, Reese, Just Want Another Chance, Incognito Records, 1988, was indeed sampled on Renegade's Terrorist and countless others since, being known simply as the Reese bass line. He followed these up with equally influential, and bassline heavy, tracks in the UK hardcore style Astronic House in 1991-1992. Another Detroit artist who was important for the scene is Carl Craig. The sampled up jazz break on Carl Craig's Bug in the Bass Bin was also influential on the newly emerging sound. DJs at the Rage Club used to play it pitched up, increased speed, as far as their Technics record decks would go. By the late 1980s and early 1990s, the tradition of breakbeat use in hip-hop production had influenced the sound of breakbeat hardcore, which in turn led to the emergence of jungle, drum and bass, and other genres that shared the same use of broken beats. Drum and bass shares many musical characteristics with hip-hop, though it is nowadays mostly stripped-off lyrics. Grandmaster Flash, Roger Troutman, Africa Bambaataa, Run DMC, Mac Dre, Public Enemy, Schoolie D, N.W.A., Kid Frost, Wu-Tang Clan, Dr. Dre, Mos Def, Beastie Boys and The Far Side are very often directly sampled, regardless of their general influence. Clearly drum and bass has been influenced by other music genres, though influences from sources external to the electronic dance music scene perhaps lessened following shifts from jungle to drum and bass, and through to so-called intelligent drum and bass and techstep. It still remains a fusion music style. Some tracks are illegally remixed and released on white label, technically bootleg, often to acclaim. For example, DJ Zinc's remix of the Fugees' Ready or Not, also known as Fugee or Not, was eventually released with the Fugees' permission after talk of legal action, though ironically the Fugees' version infringed Enya's copyright to an earlier song. White labels along with dub plates play an important part in drum and bass musical culture. The genre places great importance on the bass line, a deep sub-bass musical pattern which can be felt physically through powerful sound systems due to the low-range frequencies favored. There has been considerable exploration of different timbres in the bassline region, particularly within techstep. The basslines most notably originate from sampled sources or synthesizers. Basslines performed with a bass instrument, whether it is electric, acoustic or a double bass, are less common, but examples can be found in the work of artists such as Shapeshifter, Square Pusher, Pendulum, Roni Size and STS9. Of equal importance is the TR-808 kick drum, an artificially pitched down or elongated bass drum sound sampled from Roland's classic TR-808 drum machine, and a sound which has been subject to an enormous amount of experimentation over the years. The complex syncopation of the drum track's breakbeat is another facet of production on which producers can spend a very large amount of time. The amen break is generally acknowledged to have been the most used, and often considered the most powerful, break in drum and bass. The amen break was synonymous with early drum and bass productions, but other samples have had a significant impact, including the Apache, Funky Drummer, Soul Pride, Scorpio and Think About It, breaks. Many drum and bass tracks have featured more than one sampled breakbeat in them and a technique of switching between two breaks after each bar developed. Examples of this can be heard on mid-90s releases such as J-Magic's Your Sound. A more recent commonly used break is the Tramon, which combines the Amen break, a James Brown funk breakbeat, Tighten Up or Samurai break, and an Alex Rees drum and bass breakbeat. The relatively fast drum beat forms a canvas on which a producer can create tracks to appeal to almost any taste and often will form only a background to the other elements of the music. Syncopated breakbeats remain the most distinctive element, as without these a high-tempo 4/4 stance track could be classified as techno or gabber. Drum and bass is usually between 160 to 180 BPM, in contrast to other breakbeat-based dance styles such as new school breaks, which maintain a slower pace at around 130 to 140 BPM. A general upward trend in tempo has been observed during the evolution of drum and bass. The earliest forms of drum and bass clocked in at around 130 BPM in 1990-1991, speeding up to around 155 to 165 BPM by 1993. Since around 1996, drum and bass tempos have predominantly stayed in the 170 to 180 range. Recently, some producers have started to once again produce tracks with slower tempos, that is, in the 150s and 160s, but the mid-170 tempo is still the hallmark of the drum and bass sound. A track combining the same elements, broken beat, bass, production techniques, as a drum and bass track, but with a slower tempo, say 140 BPM, might not be drum and bass but a drum and bass influenced breakbeat track. Drum and bass exhibits a full frequency response which can sometimes only be fully appreciated on sound systems which can handle very low frequencies, including sub-bass frequencies that are often felt more than heard. As befits its name, the bass element of the music is particularly pronounced, with the comparatively sparse arrangements of drum and bass tracks allowing room for bass lines that are deeper than most other forms of dance music. Consequently, drum and bass parties are often advertised as featuring uncommonly loud and bass-heavy sound systems. There are, however, many albums specifically designed for personal listening. The mix CD is a particularly popular form of release, with a big-name DJ/producer mixing live, or on a computer, a variety of tracks for personal listening. Additionally, there are many albums containing unmixed tracks, suited for home or car listening. Many mixing points begin or end with a drop. The drop is the point in a track where a switch of rhythm or bassline occurs and usually follows a recognizable build section and breakdown. Sometimes the drop is used to switch between tracks, layering components of different tracks, though as the two records may be simply ambient breakdowns at this point, though some DJs prefer to combine breakbeats, a more difficult exercise. Some drops are so popular that the DJ will rewind or reload or lift up by spinning the record back and restarting it at the build. The drop is often a key point from the point of view of the dance floor, since the drum breaks often fade out to leave an ambient intro playing. When the beats recommence, they are often more complex and accompanied by a heavier bass line, encouraging the crowd to dance. Although it has declined in popularity, DJs are often accompanied by one or more MCs, drawing on the genre's roots in hip-hop and reggae/ragga. MCs do not generally receive the same level of recognition as producers/DJs, and some events are specifically marketed as being MC-free. There are relatively few well-known drum and bass MCs: Stevie Hyper D, Deceased, MC GQ, MC Moose, MC Det, MC Fearless, The Ragga Twins, Dynamite MC, MC Fats, MC Conrad, Shaba D, Skibidi, Bassman, MC Stamina, MC Fun, Evil B, Trigger, Eskman, Harry Shada, Mr. Traumatic and MC Infinity as examples. Many musicians have adapted drum and bass to live performances, which feature instruments such as drums, acoustic or electronic, samplers, synthesizers, turntables, bass, either upright or electric, and guitars, acoustic or electric. Samplers have also been used live by assigning samples to a specific drum pad or key on drum pads or synthesizers. MCs are frequently featured in live performances. Smaller scenes within the drum and bass community have developed, and the scene as a whole has become much more fractured into specific subgenres, including. Despite its roots in the UK, which can still be treated as the home of drum and bass, the style has firmly established itself around the world. There are strong scenes in other English-speaking countries including Australia, Canada, South Africa, the United States and New Zealand. It is popular throughout continental Europe and in South America. Sao Paulo is sometimes called the drum and bass Ibiza. Brazilian drum and bass is sometimes referred to as sambass, with its specific style and sound. In Venezuela and Mexico, artists have created their own forms of drum and bass, combining it with experimental musical forms. In Colombia there is a large underground scene. The Redotset label and Bogota Project are two collectives that put on DNB events in the city, as well as a twice-yearly event called Radical Styles, that brings together local talent and international big names. Austria has a large emerging DNB scene with many artists such as Camo and Crooked, Mephuse, Forward, Body, and Soul, Ill Skills, and mainly the Mainframe record label being all based in or around Vienna. Notable venues and events include The Hive and Beat It at Flex, held almost every Thursday and Saturday, Valkontakt at Fluke, Switch at Flex, and the monthly Mainframe Recordings label night hosted at Arena by label head Desash. The Czech Republic currently hosts the largest drum and bass festival in the world, Let It Roll, with attendance of approximately 30,000. The genre is also encountered Slovakia, and local producers in both countries like A Cray, Rito, Forbidden Society, L+, B Complex, Changing Faces, etc. becoming well known worldwide. There are several other drum and bass festivals being held each year in these countries, including Trident Festival, Exploration Festival or Hoofbeats Open Air in the summer, or one-night events such as Let It Roll Winter, Imagination Festival, Let It Roll Winter Slovakia in the colder months. During the club season, it goes without saying that promoters are racing between each other to organize better events, often resulting in 10 parties being held during one weekend with no more than 2-hour travel between them. Born around the same time as jungle, breakcore and digital hardcore share many of the elements of drum and bass, and to the uninitiated, tracks from the extreme end of drum and bass may sound identical to breakcore thanks to speed, complexity, impact and maximum sonic density combined with musical experimentation. German drum and bass DJ The Panacea is also one of the leading digital hardcore artists. Raggacore resembles a faster version of the ragga-influenced jungle music of the 1990s, similar to breakcore but with more friendly dancehall beats, dancehall itself being a very important influence on drum and bass. Darkcore, a direct influence on drum and bass, was combined with influences of drum and bass itself, leading to the creation of darkstep. There is considerable crossover from the extreme edges of drum and bass, breakcore, darkcore, digital hardcore and raggacore with fluid boundaries. The genre has influenced many other genres like hip-hop, big beat, dubstep, house music, trip-hop, ambient music, techno, rock and pop, with artists such as Bill Laswell, Incubus, Pitch Shifter, Linkin Park, The Roots, Talvin Singh, Medieval Pundits, Missy Elliott, The Freestylers, Bowery Electric, Nine Inch Nails, David Bowie, the last two both use elements of Goldie's Timeless, and others quoting drum and bass and using drum and bass techniques and elements. Recently created in the United States is a genre called ghetto tech, which contains synth and bass lines similar to drum and bass. Drum and bass is dominated by a small group of record labels. These are run mainly by DJ producers, such as London Electricity's Hospital Records, NDC and Scott Bourne's Ram, Goldie's Metalheads, Casra's Critical Music, DJ Friction's Shogun Audio, DJ Fresh's Breakbeat Chaos, Future Bounds Viper Recordings and DJ Hype, Pascal, No Copyright Sounds and formerly DJ Zinc's True Players, now known as Real Players as of 2006. Prior to 2016, the major international music labels such as Sony Music and Universal had shown very little interest in the drum and bass scene, with the exception of some notable signings, including Pendulum's In Silico LP to Warner. Roni Size's label played a big, if not the biggest, part in the creation of drum and bass with their dark, bassline sounds. V Recordings also played a large part of the development of drum and bass. Roni Size, Crust and DJ Die produced some of the first tracks to be considered mainstream drum and bass tracks. BMG Rights Management acquired Ram Records in February 2016, making a strategic investment to help Ram Records, a London-based drum and bass record company co-owned BNDC and his business partner Scott Bourne. Ram Records has been pushing the boundaries of drum and bass further into the mainstream with artists such as Chase and Status and Sub Focus. Bringing back UK jungle music artists from LTJ Bookham's label Good Looking Artists Baby Kane, Breakbeat Hardcore Heavyweight Nebula 2 and original junglist Gapaji, other Bristol labels such as Cafe Bass have also helped to push through a sound categorized as bass music with the help of influential artists such as Lone Ranger. Now defunct labels include Rob Playford's Moving Shadow, running from 1990 until 2007, which played a pivotal role in the 90s drum and bass scene, releasing records by artists such as Omni Trio. Originally, drum and bass was mostly sold in 12-inch vinyl single format. With the emergence of drum and bass into mainstream music markets, more albums, compilations and DJ mixes started to be sold on CDs. As digital music became more popular, websites focused on electronic music, such as Beatport, began to sell drum and bass in digital format. The bulk of drum and bass vinyl records and CDs are distributed globally and regionally by a relatively small number of companies such as SRD, Southern Record Distributors, ST Holdings, and New Urban. As of September 11, 2012, New Urban Music Limited ceased trading and RSM 10 and were instructed to assist in convening statutory meetings of members and creditors to appoint a liquidator. This left many labels short on sales as New Urban were one of the main distributors for the vinyl market in the drum and bass scene. Today, drum and bass is widely promoted throughout the world using different methods such as video sharing services, YouTube, Dailymotion, blogs, radio and television, the latter being the most uncommon method. More recently, music networking websites such as SoundCloud and MixCloud have become powerful tools for artist recognition, providing a vast platform that enables quick responses to new tracks. Record labels have adopted the use of podcasts. Prior to the rise of the internet, drum and bass was commonly broadcast over pirate radio. The three highest profile radio stations playing drum and bass shows are BBC Radio 1 with a drum and bass show, formerly with Friction, who was replaced with René Lavoisier in 2017, simulcast in the US and Canada on Sirius XM, and DJ Hype on Kiss 100 in London. Fabio and Groove Rider previously held a long-standing drum and bass show on Radio 1, and there was also Radio 1's One in the Jungle show. The BBC's urban station BBC Radio 1 Extra used to feature the genre heavily, with DJ Bailey, show axed as of August 29, 2012, and Chrissy Chris, show axed as of August 2014, as its advocates. The network also organises a week-long tour of the UK each year called Extra Bass. London pirate radio stations have been instrumental in the development of drum and bass, with stations such as Cool FM, which continues to broadcast today having done so since 1991, Origin FM, Don FM, the only drum and bass pirate to have gained a temporary legal license, Renegade Radio 107.2 FM, Root FM, Wax FM and Eruption among the most influential. As of 2014, despite higher-profile stations such as One Extra scaling back their drum and bass specialist coverage, the genre has made its way into UK top 10 charts with drum and bass-inspired tracks from artists such as Rudimental and Sigma. Earlier in August 2014, before Chrissy Chris' show was axed, the BBC held a whole prime-time evening event dedicated to showcasing drum and bass by allowing four major labels to participate. As of November 2014, there have been six drum and bass songs reaching the number one spot on the UK's Top 40 chart, since the genre was first being played on the radio, around 1993. The first of these was in 2012. The fact that all six of these songs have reached number one in only 2 years shows the increase in popularity and commercialization of the genre in recent years. The artists that produced these songs are Sigma, Rudimental and DJ Fresh, all have had two number one hits. Internet radio stations, acting in the same light as pirate stations, have also been an instrumental part in promoting drum and bass music, the majority of them funded by listener on artist donations. Drum and bass was supported by Ministry of Sound Radio from the early 2000s until 2014 and later featuring Tuesday shows from labels such as Metalheads, Fabio, and Groove Rider, DJ Marky, Viper Recordings, Shogun Audio, and Hospital Records. From September 2014, Ministry abruptly dropped all non-mainstream genres to focus on mainstream EDM, causing disappointment amongst the fans of the DNB community. In North America, The Prophecy on 89.5 JIT FM with Marcus Visionary, DJ Prime and Mr. Brown is North America's longest-running jungle radio show, Toronto, Album 88.5, Atlanta, and C89.5 FM, Seattle, have shows showcasing drum and bass. In New York, dnbnoise radio show with host DJ Ben Sakane on 90.3 WHCR FM has a weekly 3-hour show which broadcasts in New York and New Jersey which plays only drum and bass every Thursday starting at 3 a.m. dnbnoise radio is the only weekly drum and bass show on the FM dial in northeastern United States. Seattle also has a long-standing electronica show known as Expansions and 90.3 FM KEXP. The rotating DJs include Kid Hops, whose shows are made up mostly of drum and bass. In Columbus, Ohio, WCBE 90.5 has a 2-hour electronic-only showcase, All Mixed Up, Saturday nights at 10 p.m. At the same time, WUFM 88.7 plays its electronic playground. Also, Tulsa, Oklahoma's rock station, 104.5 The Edge, has a 2-hour show starting at 10 p.m. Saturday nights called Edge Essential Mix, mixed by DJ Demko, showcasing electronic and drum and bass style. While the aforementioned shows in Ohio rarely play drum and bass, the latter plays the genre with some frequency. In Tucson, Arizona, 91.3 FM KXCI has a 2-hour electronic show known as Digital Empire, Friday nights at 10 p.m., MST. Resident DJ Trinidad showcases various styles of electronica, with the main focus being drum and bass, jungle and dubstep. In Augusta, Georgia, Zarbazar of the Serial Killers hosts a show called Frequency on WHHD on Friday nights from 11 p.m. until 1 a.m., showcasing drum and bass during the second hour of the show. The best-known drum and bass publication was Comeg Magazine, formerly called Knowledge Magazine, before it went completely online in August 2009. Although it still live, after 20 years Comeg ceased updating their site at the end of 2014. Comeg's publishing arm Vision published Brian Balfourchon's All Cruise Journeys Through Jungle Drum and Bass Culture in 2004. Other publications include the longest-running drum and bass magazine worldwide, ATM Magazine, and Austrian-based Resident. London-based DJ Magazine has also been running a widely respected drum and bass reviews page since 1993, written by Alex Constantinidis, which many followers refer to when seeking out new releases to investigate. In 2012, Alex stopped writing the reviews and they are now contributed by Whiskey Kicks. Certain drum and bass releases have found mainstream popularity in their own right, almost always material prominently featuring vocals. Perhaps the earliest example was Goldie's album Timeless from 1995, along with Represents Mercury Music Prize-winning New Forms from 1997. Four Heroes Mercury nominated Two Pages from 1998, and Pendulum's Hold Your Color in 2005, the best-selling drum and bass album of all time. Video games such as Bomberman Hero, Hi-Rez Studios, Electronic Arts, and Rockstar Games' Grand Theft Auto series have contained drum and bass tracks. Microsoft Studios' Forza Horizon 2 and 3 feature a Hospital Records radio channel. MSX / radio station in Grand Theft Auto 3 and play drum and bass exclusively. The genre has some popularity in soundtracks. For instance, ultrasonic sound was used in The Matrix's soundtrack and the Easy Rollers' song Walk This Land appeared in the film Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. Ganja Crew's Super Sharpshooter is heard in the 2006 film Johnny Was. The Channel 4 show Skins uses the genre in some episodes, notably in the first series' third episode, Jaw, where Shy FX and UK Apache's original Nutta was played in Phaser's Club. Lately, Drum and bass have found more mainstream popularity than ever with tracks like Sigma's Nobody to Love and Rudimental's Waiting All Night getting over 100 million views on YouTube. Drum and bass often makes an appearance as background music, especially in Top Gear and television commercials thanks to its aggressive and energetic beats. Cartoon Network's Toonami programming block employs it for television spots and show intros, like the 1997 relaunch of Sci-Fi Channel Segway Music by the Jungle Sky label. Also the first Powerpuff Girls series opening is drum and bass / jungle, as well as the opening of Teen Titans Go. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.